Can we just give the round of applause to the jazz band? And especially Mr. Arthur, who has looked after them and made them very professional. So thank you very much. Can I now call up Mrs. Dryden to open the evening of Oscars 2023?
Just before I begin, can I ask, please, that students, if you want to let your parents and whānau know that this evening, if you haven't already done so, is being live streamed through our Howick College Facebook page, can I ask you just to do that now? And then I'm going to ask that you just turn your mobile phones off, please. To our invited guests, can I also ask you to do the same? Thank you. So we'll just give you a moment to do that and then we'll begin. Tenakoto, tenakoto, tenakoto katoa, no mai, haere mai, and welcome. Welcome to this year's Oscars theme celebration evening as we come together with Farno and friends near and afar. To our students, staff, invited guests, our BOT, senior leadership team and the Lions of Howick, we thank each and every one of you for your continued support. Te toifa kairau, ka ihihihi, ka wehi wehi ka auwai, auwai te au katoa. Artistic excellence makes the world sit up in wonder. Can I just ask Etu that we just stand for a karakia, please, to open this evening? Kia hora tira marino, kia whakapapa tunamu timuana. Hei hurahi ma tātou I te rangi nei, aroha atu, aroha mai, tātou ia tātou katoa. May peace be widespread. May the sea be like greenstone, a pathway for us all this day. Let us show respect for each other, for one another, bind us all together. Tonight we acknowledge and thank each and every one of you who have played your part in our journey this year. To the expressive arts team and our itinerant music staff, your commitment, passion, unwavering support, and the multiple opportunities that you give our Konga, thank you. Parents, caregivers and whānau, for your support along the way, the late night pickups, the early morning drop-offs, the taxi service that you have run consistently over weekends, through holidays, rehearsals, workshops, we thank you. To our students, tonight is a celebration of each and every one of you, those that are here, afar and in absentia, without which tonight wouldn't even be possible. To those receiving award, I would like you to remember that it is the mahi of many that have enabled you to succeed and reach and excel your potential. I hara taku toa I te toa takitahi, engari he a toa takatini. Just as it takes a village to raise a child, it takes a community and a team to enable an individual success, and we're all part of that team. Despite yet another challenging year, Natoi, the arts have continued to thrive, grow and create within and beyond our kura for the Howick College community, for our whānau and surrounding communities, to rekindle partnerships across the road with Cockle Bay Primary and anew with Botany Primary, paving the way forward for our tamariki and generations to come. We come together on this day and celebrate all of your mahi and collective successes. To those again watching from afar, haere mai and welcome. We know you are here in spirit. We also take a moment to pause, to reflect, and acknowledge the challenges faced globally at this time, and to acknowledge the important part that the arts have to play, because they can bring a moment's joy, laughter, transport us somewhere new, a place where we can escape, to connect and instill kinship, to uplift, to acknowledge heart and soul, humanity. All great artists draw from the same resource, and that is the human heart, which tells us that we're actually more alike than we are unalike. Students, this is your space and your place. Please remember that, because you have given so much to the arts, to each other, to others beyond our kura. So please keep doing what you love to make a difference in this world. For if music be the food of love, play on. To Mrs. Debbie Schoper, our arts coordinator, we thank you for your organisation of this event, for bringing the arts together once again so we can celebrate as we do annually, because we couldn't do this without you. So can we just please acknowledge Mrs. Debbie Schoper? So just before I pass over to Mr. Matthew O'Ryan, our head of music, there's a little bit of housekeeping. In the unlikely event of an emergency, we ask that you go to the main front car park. When we are calling out the nominees for an award, we will then announce the recipient of that award. Can that person or persons please make their way up the red carpet onto the stage where you will be presented with your award? We can then applaud. Can I ask then that you go down the stairs to my right, round down the corridor to D9, the main dance space where your photo will be taken with our photographers this evening, both are former Howick College students, Crystal and Maylin. So again, welcome to you two. And then you will come back through the doors where they're currently standing. Would you just like to give everybody a wave? Okay. Partway through the evening, we will take a pause where we can just fill our cup, literally, metaphorically speaking, with some refreshments. Guests, I will take you over to the main staff room. Students, you will go through to D10, where there's some yummy kai waiting for you. This is also an opportunity to acknowledge Samantha Gomez, who was awarded yesterday evening at the Year 13 Senior Honours as our Top Performing Arts recipient, and a very well-deserved award to Samantha Gomez, who's currently with the Jazz Band. Can we please give her another round of applause? Stakes are high, and it's not always easy when we have such amazing young people in front of us, but remember, you're all part of that journey. I think the last thing that I need to, two last things, if you need our bathrooms, hopefully by now you know where they are, to my left, through there, to my right, through here. We appear to have quite a few absences today, so please, if we are announcing someone and they don't come up the red carpet, can we please ask that someone who is in that class, on that course, or in that year level, please just come up and receive the award on their behalf. It means you get your photo taken with an award. And we'd just be really grateful of that. So without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Mr. Matthew O'Ryan to present the music awards.
Tēnā koutou. Good evening, everybody. As Mrs. Ryan just said, I'm going to hand out some music awards. Everybody that comes up today is going to be a winner for music. I'm going to give out medals for extracurricular participation in groups of instruments. And then there are going to be two special people drawn out of that group that are going to get Oscars for music extracurricular participation for 2023. The first group of people, you can applaud each one because I think they're all individually equal. The first group, though, is for contribution to extracurricular music at Howick College for bowed strings, that is violins, violas, cellos and double basses. There are four recipients of these medals, in no particular order. Samantha Gomez. As most people know, Samantha Gomez is an amazing cello player. Second person in the group, amazing violin player, Karis Lim. Karis Lim is also the leader of the orchestra. To every leader is a great co-leader. Co-leader of the orchestra is violin player Sean Huang. And finally, in this first group, we also have another orchestra string player, but this time we have our amazing double bass player, Zoe Dixon. This is the first time I've given a double bass player an award for some time, so well done. Category is contribution to music extracurricular activities. These people are my go-to vocalists. There are two people. very important people. You know them very well. Firstly, Hope Milo. No particular order. We can't carry on without acknowledging Katie Rose Pemberton. And you will get to hear these people sing for you later in the ceremony. Category is as brass instruments or our brass instruments. One person here, trumpet player Finn O'Sullivan. Here we have woodwind players in the front row of the jazz band. I've awarded 2 medals for contribution to music in Howick College in woodwind playing. And the first person, Jack Stiles. Thank you. stage for their OSCA, which is their overall commitment to music at Howick College. These are in no particular order, or kind of alphabetical order. So, Samantha Gomez.
So that's an opportunity for you to see the amazing work that the senior students do, because often it's hidden and squirreled away in the art rooms and you don't get to see it quite as much as we do with the bands and with the performing arts. So please take that opportunity. Tonight for our Oscars, we have a number of categories that we are presenting. We will let you know who the nominees are and we'll let you know then who the winner of those areas are. So our first one is the Chuck Close Award for the Most Realistic Drawing and Painting. Our nominees for this is Talia Kennedy, Leah Cornell, and Annalise Emerson. And the winner is... Chuck Close Award for the Most Realistic Drawing and Painting is Talia Kennedy. And the winner is Anya Kwasa. Our nominees are Monique Creasy, Annalise Emerson, and Kelly Zhu. And the winner is Monique Creasy.
Then we go back.
Our nominees are Talia Kennedy, Mitsuru Nishikawa, Monique Preisig, and our winner is Mitsuru Nishikawa. Across a range of media and across a range of subjects. These students work hard. Those of you who are working on portfolios at the moment know how much work goes into one, let alone doing numerous ones across your senior year. Our winner for the best art practice is Monique Preisig.
Back to the jazz band to let them finish their last piece of the evening. So please enjoy.
Thank you very much, everyone. And thank you to the sound guys for putting on the microphone. Awesome. We're delighted to be here this evening. Of course, the jazz band, we really look forward to this event. So we were a pleasure for us to play for you earlier today. But we're going to do a little presentation item now. And we're going to invite Hope Milo down to sing a song with us. So if Hope, you're out there, if you could make your way down. Great to see you. Hope Milo. It really has been a pleasure for me working with these young musicians this year. Fantastic group of young people, and especially I'd like to take a moment to thank our Year 13s, many of whom have given over 3 or 4 years of service to the band, and they've been absolutely wonderful musicians and great people at the same time. Jack Stiles, Emily Lamour, Karis Lynn, and Samantha Gomez, our Year 13s. Could you please give it up for them? And we're going to finish things off for us this evening with a great piece by Portugal the Man, who a band, sort of hip band from the last few years, and this is their biggest hit. It's called Feel It Still, and it's going to feature Hope on vocals, of course, and Jack on saxophone solo. Thank you so much. This is Feel It Still.
Hands to myself, think I'll dust them off, put them back up on the shelf, in case my little baby girl is in need. Am I coming out of left field? Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks, yeah. I've been feeling it since 1966, yeah. Might be over now, but I feel it still. Another mouth to feed. Leave it with the babysitter. Mama called the grave digger. Gone with the fallen leaves. Am I coming out of left field? Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks, yeah. Never feeling like it's 1966, yeah. Might be over now. A war for peace. Giving to that easy living. Goodbye to my hopes and dreams. Stop flipping for my enemies. We can wait until the walls come down.
Hofido, ladies and gentlemen. The amazing Jack Styles on the saxophone. And the Howick College Jazz Band. Thank you so much.
Wonderful music again. Thank you, Mr. Arthur and the jazz band. Can I please call up Mr. Oi to do the media awards?
Kia ora koutou, everyone. Handing out awards for media production this year. So we've got four from year 10 to year 13. Starting off, so I think this is year 10. So year 10, can we get Riley Barrett coming up? Year 11, we've got Aria Tackle Lee, Isabella Murray, and Olivia Handley. Seems to turn up. Alex Penny. Hey everyone.
Tonight goes to the Advanced Open Debating in recognition for their commitment to debating over the last 5 years through the COVID chapter when they had to go online. They haven't faltered. They have been a courageous group collaborating and strategizing remarkably well. And this year, the reason they were not through to the finals was because they were volunteering for flood relief. So I think those were all highly commendable. So could I know you're not all here tonight, but could I have Violet, I know, is here, and Violet, Jus, Sihandu, and Maya are the
I got what I need, yeah, yeah. I see that light in the morning, shining down on me. So give me your power, take me Kat.
Hello. Don't worry, we know this has been a long week, full of honours and assemblies, and we're all tired. We want to finish school now, so we're going to keep this short. Good evening to our parents, teachers, special guests, and of course all the incredible nominees that have joined us here on this gorgeous night of celebration, acknowledgement, and of course the arts. I'm Monique.
And I'm Julie.
And we are so lucky to have been the Arts Council Leaders of 2023. Now, before saying another word, as Arts Council Leaders, we would like to wholeheartedly thank our amazing council and Queen Shoba.
This year, the Arts Council have taken part in many different school and community events, including
the Botany Dance Mural Project
and the Dance Showcase, of course.
And who can forget the fake blood that coated every single surface within a 10k radius of the theatre during the senior production of Lord of the Flies?
This year has flown by, and we are so proud and privileged to have led the Arts Council, and I'm certain that the memories we have made this year will always be remembered and cherished.
And now, before we continue with the awards, there are some very important people that need acknowledging for all of their hard work and contribution this year. Can we please have a round of applause for all of our amazing teachers that have put their hearts into helping us succeed? And can we also invite our Slay Warrior Queen, Miss Dryden, to the stage? Miss Dryden has devoted insane amounts of time and effort into seeing the art department achieve, as well as putting on some epic productions. We cannot thank her enough for all that she has done as the head of the art department.
Next, our Arts Council. Could you guys all put your hand up? Thank you all for always being available and always willing to help with any and every school events, whether it be making decorations on the floor of the drama classes at lunch or staying at school until 9 p.m. in the kitchen or backstage of all productions and station, all productions and showcases.
Thank you.
And everyone that is invited tonight, we would like to acknowledge you guys once again for not just the medals you've won, but your dedication, the countless hours of practice, and every story is behind your hard work.
Another important group of people we obviously have to acknowledge are the parents, caregivers, and extended family and friends. Without their support and dedication to our education and interests, we would never be able to get anywhere. Thank you for being our personal Ubers, cheerleaders, and so much more. You guys are paramount to our success, and we will forever be grateful.
Let's go, Mum and Spain!
And finally, last but not least, Ms. Shoba, could you please come up to the stage?
Your dedication to this school, the arts department, and our council is incredible and most certainly does not go unnoticed. We thank you for all that you have given us, not just this year, but throughout the last five. Thank you for all the support, school-related or not, the fun memories, and all of the schlays. We will never forget our year as leaders, and we will never, ever forget your constant and unwavering support. So that's it from us now. Enjoy the rest of the evening, and continue with the awards.
Thank you.
Thank you. And now we have our recognition medals for our Student Arts Council this year. These go to some incredible students that have done so much more work, put in so much heart and time into helping our council get where it is now, including setting up the toll area today. Thank you for that. The recognition medals for the Student Arts Council this year for outstanding achievement go to Abigail Murko. Darcy Murphy. Winter Lynn. Isabel Freesig.
shoot with the eyes. Come on down to the front, stay right here and don't be shy. I have you time traveling, have your mind.
Okay, thank you, Monique and Julie. Wonderful job. Thank you, Student Arts Council. You're awesome. I do have two awards, two Oscars here for my beautiful Arts Council leaders, which are Monique and Julie. Please give them a round of applause. Okay, we will now have a short break for refreshments. Could I ask the guests to go over to the staff room where everything is set out for you and my lovely front row will look after you. Students into D9, enjoy.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome back. I hope you've all enjoyed your little break. Can I now call up Katie and Hope?
Today we're going to be singing Let Me Be Your Star.
Fade in on a girl with a hunger for fame, with a face and a name to remember.
The past fades away, because as of this day, Norma Jean's gone. She's moving on. Her smile and your fantasies play a duet that will make you forget where you are.
Thank you so much, Ms. Schofer. Before we begin, I just want to say a massive thank you to our beautiful dance team, Ms. Rogerson, Ms. Britton, our Holla Jilly. We miss you, Mrs. Thomas, and we think of you all the time. Thank you so much, Arts Council, and our gorgeous technicians for all your hard work you've done this year. All our nominees are very deserving. Our first one is Dance Recognition Medals. This year, they are going to the students who gained a high excellence in every single one of their performance repertoire pieces. To gain a high excellence in dance, you essentially need to have performed it better than the choreographer could have ever dreamed it would look. That's normally us. I'm going to read them all, and I want you guys to come up on the stage and stand there so everyone can see how gorgeous you are. First of all, in absentia, we have Addison and Alyssa Whitten. We also have Gabriella Indaba. Aria Tackle-Lee. Holly Wellham. Isabella Murray. And lastly, Lily Grigg. Next award is for Best Upcoming Choreographer. This is someone throughout the year who has produced exquisite choreography and is on the beginning of their choreography journey. The nominees are Liliana Rose Time, Isabella Murray, Cade Toya, and Gabriella Indaba. The winner is Liliana Rose Time. One of the highlights of Showcase was our beautiful class dance for Cardi and Mai, which could not have looked so exquisite without Liliana's beautiful choreography. Woohoo! Our next award is Choreographer of the Year. This is normally to a Year 13 student who has done superb choreography. This year there are no nominees, just a winner, who gained a beautiful excellence in her 3.1, which is the hardest internal you can do in dance with 8 credits, and also choreographed our lovely opening number. This year, our choreographer of the year for 2023 is Asher Saunders. Junior Dancer of the Year. This is a Year 9 or Year 10 student who has been outstanding throughout the year. Again, this year we have no nominees, just one winner, because they are that fabulous. They are a real all-rounder and they go above and beyond. This year's Junior Dancer of the Year is Riley Barrett. best upcoming all-round dancer. This is a dancer who has shown excellent technique across a wide range of styles. The nominees for best upcoming all-round dancer are Isabella Murray, Alyssa Whitten, Gabriella Indaba, Liv Ahrens, Finn O'Sullivan, and Hayley Johnson. The winner is Finn O'Sullivan. Finn gets this award despite the fact he would not kick at 90 degrees like he was told to. He went above and beyond. Our next award is for Best All-Round Dancer of the Year. This normally goes to a Year 13 student who has shown superb effort and techniques across a wide range of genres and performance skills. To me, the Best All-Round Dancer is someone who not only dances well, but is an all-round beautiful human who shows kindness and helpfulness to everyone in their class. The nominees are Amy Logan, Asha Saunders, Willow Mochuliki, Sophie Homan, and Samantha Bryant. The winner is Asha Saunders. And dancer for this year, and we're so pleased to announce that she's going on to the University of Auckland next year for a Bachelor of Dance Studies. Our next award is the Four C's Award. It's really important in dance that you embody the spirit of Howick College and you show commitment, courage, courtesy, and curiosity at all times. Our nominees for this award is Bhavia Madden, Lucy O'Hanlon, Brenna McLaughlin, and for our first, our beautiful technician, Carlos Robinson-Franny. Carlos did go above and beyond with all of our video editing and just everything. This year's Four C's Award goes to Brenna McLaughlin. Is the Achiro Harada Award. Achiro Harada was a dance teacher at Howick College a few years ago. He is absolutely amazing. He started this award, which is to go to a Year 13 who has done dance since Year 9 for the past 5 years and shown outstanding commitment, perseverance, and overall just amazingness throughout their time here. This year, we had 25 possible students this could go to. We had so many who have continued to take dance since Year 9. The nominees for this award is Elizabeth Hills, Zoe Parnell, Amy Clifford, and Willow Mochuliki. And the winner of the Achiro Harada Award is Willow Mochuliki.
please invite Miss Dryden up to the stage for some drama awards.
Okay, so I'm going to improv this bit while I wait for my first little envelope. It's there. I really am ready for the weekend. It's behind me. Where? Oh, there. I'm just going to do a little bit of publicity, if I may, at the moment. So the lovely lady to my right here, Monique, acknowledged all the blood through the building earlier in the year. I seem to have this trend of sand and blood and soil and big cleanup afterwards that involves far too many people and vacuum cleaners. I digress. But every year we entertain our shows in something called the Auckland Live Showdown Awards. And we're up against other schools. I'm never in it to win it, because it is about celebrating and showcasing each and every drama student that is a part of that opportunity within the Auckland area. And let's face it, there's some pretty awesome schools out there. I know quite a few of the kaiako that teach in those schools, and they're incredible teachers. Again, it's a chance for our technicians and the people that work behind stage, the people that help with the designing, to all come together in this space and for that work to be recognised. So when we do get nominations, it's again that collective that has enabled for that one or two or more people just to be recognised. So if you're not doing anything on Tuesday night and want to go onto Ticketmaster and purchase your $20 ticket and join us at the Bruce Mason Centre, we have got several of our students there recognised for their hard work as part of a wider team. We would love to see some of you there. Some of those students might grace the stage now as we present some of our drama awards. But that is in recognition of our senior girls production, year 12 and 13, working together with the co-direction of Erin and myself, and our year 12 and 13 boys working together with the co-direction of Kellen and myself. So can we just give all of those students and our techies involved and our arts and please invite Miss Anna Rogerson to the stage just to help me with these. Thank you. So in term one, we also have the opportunity to part of the SCGCNZ Otago University Shakespeare Sheilawin Festival, and I do actually have to acknowledge that very long title. Again, it's about getting out there, celebrating the work of the bard, whose work is still celebrated 400 years after his death. Fun fact, if you didn't know it, he was born and died on the same day, not in the same year, however. This year we had several teams represent Howick College at the Auckland South and East Regional Heats. Again, not directed by me this year, but again by Jack Schluse and Ashley Simon, who did leave our school earlier in the year. But I just would like to acknowledge those two students for their work. Can we do that now, please? Okay, so we have some recognition medals. Can I first invite to the stage, please? So this is recognition medals for performances of that event, Alex Hardacre. Connor Peters, who's in absentia this evening. Callum Nichols. Kate Baxter. Freya Newbold, who's currently in Australia, and I have an up-to-date account while she's performing overseas, apparently is a German pig. Have I got that correct? Her mum's over there if you need to find out more details later. takes all sorts, it changes up from being a tree. Louis Camus. Brothers. So joining our actors on stage, we have other areas that were entered this year. So for musical composition of an instrumental composition, can I please also invite to the stage to join these lovely people, Samantha Gomez. And
And I'd also like to invite to the stage for their costumier design, Jessica Burr. I'd like our recipients to stay on the stage, please, just for a little bit longer. Because we have a couple of other students who are probably sitting there wondering why they're not here. Do we have... can I please have the other envelope? I'd like them to join them on stage. So as part of the recognition of this event, we have an award that's called the Bard. So the Bard is William Shakespeare. We actually have two recipients for this award this year. So theatre's not just about the acting, it's about all the different components. So our Bard Award for 2023 for acting is Lucy Loney. And our recipient for musical vocal composition, I'll announce the name in a minute, along with Sam got to go to the national festivals in June, so Sam was highly commended for her instrumentation. And the other recipient I'm calling to the stage who received first place for vocal composition at the national festival is Hope Milo. Some of you think acting's hard, directing's even harder. Some of you have done that this year. You've stepped into my shoes and it is not easy. You've put up with me, you've co-directed with me, and I just want to acknowledge those two students know who they are, but for the 2023 Ben Egan Award, Ben Egan is a former student and alumni of Howick College, who's an incredible, kind human being, the Director's Cut Awards go to. Erin Masters and Kellen Talbot. Musical places and just move the staff around as we do these last few awards. So Ria Amandin again is a former alumni of Howick College. I wish you had the privilege of meeting her. Her younger sister also came through our doors. So this is for the Four Seas Award. Now this student is familiar to a lot of you in the room. This student, this young lady was here yesterday evening receiving an award for a very similar nature. She is an all-rounder, she is kind, she is funny. She writes really good songs, by the way. And she's so deserving of this award and much more. Can we please invite to the stage Katie Rose Pemberton? Invite Miss Laura Britton to the stage as we play that musical Chairs. Again, a lot of you in the room, including my colleagues, won't know Catherine Armstrong. Debbie and I, we've been here a while, so we very much remember Catherine. She is an incredible human being. She is currently with the BBC Newsroom in the UK. She has also graced her way through this space as a debater, as a performer, as a writer, speaking at the Anzac Dawn services as part of the wider community. She's making her mark in this world, so just remember, team, anything and everything is possible. So this is for an award in excellence. Now, excellence comes in lots of shapes and sizes. It's not always about that top E, okay? I'm always whizzing around when students pass external exams and they've achieved to the utmost best, because then I know that we have done our job. So remember, excellence comes in all shapes and sizes. You've all worked really hard for everything you've achieved this year and over the last 5 years. With COVID, weather, industrial action, just remember that. This particular person has grown from strength to strength. They are humble, they are kind, they are open to learning, they're willing to grow and know what they need to do more and do better. They park their drama at the door and deal with just the drama on the script. I couldn't think of somebody more deserving for this award in excellence. Byron Larsen, could you please come? Yeah. If you need him to bake you a cake, I just want you to know that. You see, there's a bit of a theme. We've got a lot of our alumni recognised in these awards. They've made their mark in our kura for us as teachers. So this is the Stuart Shacklock Award. This is for outstanding achievement. Again, that can be recognised in so many ways and not just a grade on a piece of paper. We have one recipient, no other nominees. This student is in year 11. They're involved in all areas of the performing arts. They have a voice that has been recognised at KBB. They are going to go places. I think when you hear the name, you'll agree with me on that. Aria Takulo. So along with all the other scholarship people in the room, all the best for that, because that's not an easy gig, and I certainly wouldn't do it. So well done, Aria. Right. In traditional Oscar mode, we're now into the Actor Awards. Oh, yeah. Oh. It wasn't easy, so thank you for making our job really difficult this year. Best Actor in a Male Role. The nominees are Kellen Talbot, Xavier Simpson, Alex Hardacre, Moss Carruthers, Finn O'Sullivan, and Connor Peters. Just dragging it out. This year's recipient is Kellen Talbot. There are supporting roles. This year, our nominees for the best supporting role in a play: Harry Lee Noel Bell, Katie Gribble, Sky Swales, and Josh Cunningham. And this year's recipient goes to Harry Lee Noel Bell. For Best Actor in a Female Role, the nominees are Katie Rose Pemberton, Hope Milo, Lola Taban, Aria Tackle-Lee, and Chloe Smith.
Woo! This year's award goes to Chloe Smith.
Chloe's actually in absentia this evening, so I don't know if someone would like to come up on her behalf to receive that award. There goes Ellen. Best newcomer. There's always that new kid on the block, eh? That person that's curious enough to go, what is this drama thing all about? I hope it was worth it. This year we have two recipients. Connor Peters, who is in absentia this evening, but also the lovely Xavier Simpson. Join us for the last couple before we invite some other guests to the stage. So for those of you that don't know, my background was actually behind the scenes. I'm never really comfortable being up here. So this award is really close to my heart, which is theatre design and technology. Without the lights, we aren't seen. Without the microphone, very often I'm not heard. I need to speak louder. But it's everything that goes on behind the scenes is just as important as the actors on stage. So this year we have one recipient. He's been at our school 5 years. He doesn't like to go home. Very often I have to kick him out of here at 11:30 at night. I'd like to acknowledge all of the lights have come from his house. The computer up there, I believe, is also his at the moment. So some of you will know who this is already, but can we please welcome to the stage Andrew Kennedy. Go On Award joined this event a few years into the event. The story behind it is we did a musical and I ended up on stage playing the role of Cosmo Brown, who's a comedian. And I made everybody laugh for the wrong reasons. I slipped in the space, I broke my wrist, I was carrying a year 13 piggybacking through the space, cream pies, you get the idea, playing the role of a guy. I learned a lot that year about what it's like to be back in the space with our young people. The Show Must Go On Award is recognising two students this evening. Sometimes we have to step into the breach. Sometimes things change on a night. Sometimes there are people that will step in at the last minute and do things unexpectedly. And there are a lot of you in the room that are always doing that. These two young men stepped in for different reasons. So before I share their names with you, because of COVID, the uncertainty, we had a young man willing to take on the role of others, that just in case. So we're being proactive this year. The other young man that I'm going to acknowledge this evening is someone the day before a show stepped in. I know the lines. I know what I'm doing. I've been rehearsing with that character in the space. I've got this. And that takes courage when you've not actually rehearsed the role. You've just been stood by that person in a space knowing what they should be doing. For the other student, they've played two roles this year across the whole season. That is not easy. And they upheld their promise that they made at the beginning of that journey. So can we please welcome to the stage Alex Hardacre and Christian Dryden.
happy. As you can see, the table's nearly empty. We're nearly there. And then those of you going on to parties, enjoy yourselves, just stay safe. This is the Hidden Treasure Award. There are again those people that are in the background. Ah, I wonder who this could be. We know him quite well. Better do a good job next year as one of our student leaders. Can we welcome to the stage Carlos Robinson? Yeah. This is where we are going to welcome in two settings our Lions Foundation from Howick. So first of all, I'd like to invite Alan Sheath to the stage. And depending on which one I'm given first will determine which lovely lady I invite to join him.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Alan Sheath. I belong to the Lions Club of Howick, and with me tonight to present the award is Shauna Eldridge, who's our first Vice President. A little bit about this award, the Derek Wigsell Award for Excellence in Drama. Derek was a member of our Lions Club for 20 years and served his community well. But outside of Lions, he was an actor, a singer, a writer, a poet. He just loved the performing arts. And when Derek passed away, we thought, how can we possibly recognise Derek going forward? And so we thought the best thing would be to present to Howick College an award for excellence in drama. So I would hand over Miss Dryden now to give the citation for this year's award.
This decision has not been made easily. There are so many of you in the room that I would love to give this award to, and I can only choose one. So again, I just ask that you acknowledge that you've all been part of this particular person's journey to receive this. From Greece to Lord of the Flies, this year's recipient has taken on many roles, showing diversity across the repertoire, which continues to grow. From behind the scenes as stage crew to performing on it, and more recently, directing others. You continue to explore the world of theatre and all that it has to offer. Starting your journey in year 9, unassuming, full of energy, you have taken us on a journey. Taking to our stage with your debut multi-rolling in Brex Wojciech as Colonel, narrator, chorus. A piece that left its mark on all of us. Peace. Pulse. Of which Mr. Roparty said, what? I don't get it. You stepped into the breach when others needed help with Astroman's Mick the Bully as he pedalled through the space to taunt Hemi at the start of this year. Embracing the role of Jack in the classic Lord of the Flies, as well as co-directing and leading a team of year 12 and 13 collectively through weather challenges and industrial action. But you never gave up. It was about telling the story. It was about honouring the craft of theatre to make something beautiful, not credits, and I really will remember that conversation for the rest of my time as a teacher. You have always remained true to yourself, curious to learn and to continue to grow your craft. You are not afraid to take new opportunities as they arise to help be the best that you can be. Whilst the journey hasn't been an easy one, we have seen you bloom into the young adult that you have become. Someone who embraces the moment and captures their audience's attention wholeheartedly and with awe. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women are merely players. They have their exits, their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts. Kellen, The passion and dedication that you have given to drama and the performing arts has been inspirational for so many of us along the way, always seeking to improve and rise to the legacy left before you and with humility. It has been a privilege to be a part of your journey, watching you overcome many challenges along the way. We wish you all the very best as you begin new adventures. And for someone who has remained true to themselves as you step off this walker and onto the next, we wish you all the very best. Kellen Talbot. Invite Tina to join the stage with Alan.
So joining me on the stage now is this year's IU president, is Tina Singh. This next award is not presented by the Lions Club of Howick at all. It was actually presented by Howick College for a Lion of Howick. Ian Packwood has had an association with this college for 50 years. In various roles, but the one thing that he loved was young people. He did so many things in Young Speechmakers, Ambassadors Award, Peace Posters, very much involved with the fireworks that used to take place here many, many years ago as well. But above all, Ian was a humanitarian. He served for 56 years as a member of the Lions Club of Howick, constantly serving, always looking after others, before himself. So again, I would like to hand over to Ms. Dryden to talk about the citation for this award.
So this is actually acknowledging a rising star. Again, it has been a really difficult decision to make, but I hope that you will eventually join hands and acknowledge this lovely person. As our kura, our vision is to inspire a community of passionate learners. Ian, who I did have the privilege to meet and know for a really long time, was the epitome of this vision, even at the age of 90, inspiring his community as a lifelong learner. It is not the dates that matter, it is what one does with the dash in between. And Ian did so much with that dash. And for any of you in the room that will have met Ian will know that. This year again, we recognise Ian and the many who follow in his footsteps to continue making a difference for our youth and our communities, with the same kindness and humility as Ian. For the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. That's quoting Mahatma Gandhi. Monique, you are always smiling with an abundance of energy and positivity for those around you. A passionate, committed and determined young woman. Leading from the front, leading within the team, leading from the shadows a lot of the time. You have a voice and one that supports others, uplifting them in moments of doubt, cheering them on from the sidelines, smiling, laughing, giving praise and nurturing them as you go. Diligent, caring, funny and empathetic, courteous to others and courageous enough to stand up and speak out. You're intelligent, compassionate and a people's person. Your passion for the arts, the visual arts in particular, is a highly creative young woman who approaches all you do with enthusiasm and a can-do attitude. Monique, you have developed and upheld your super leadership capabilities with Julie on the Arts Council this year, whilst remaining humble and supportive within the wider team. You bring out the best in others, enabling confidence and uplifting manner. You have given so much without a second glance. A quick wit and joy to those to work around you. Keep striving to make a difference because you are shaping the future. Monique Prezig. Thank you. Chopra back to the stage.
Well, that is the end of our evening, unfortunately. I'm sure you've all had a lot of fun, have you?
Yeah.
Well, I want to wish you all well in your journey. Have a safe journey home tonight, and we'll see you around. Thank you.